Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I want to talk about something that I've been meaning to talk about for a very long time. Even before I turned 25, I was able to save enough money with myself to put together the down payment for my own apartment. And I was able to invest in an apartment that I now call my own before I turned 25 or before I even got married. Here are some glimpses of the apartment that I invested in. What I want to talk about in this video is the process which allowed me to make this possible at an age which is generally considered a little young for an investment like this. No, I wasn't making a lot of money. I was just making smart decisions with saving and investing it. Honestly, the process is not only to be followed for buying an apartment. You can follow it for any big investment that you want to make. It could be for a college program that you're targeting that has a high fees, or you want to buy a car. It could be anything. The goals may change, but the process will remain the same. So let's begin with the first step of the process, which is setting your goals and your targets. Now, the most important thing here is to have your goals and your targets very clear in your head. A lot of times we have these fleeting thoughts and we think about them once in a while, but the most important thing is to actually write them down so that they actually become formal targets for you to follow. Now, in my case, my target was very simple. I just wanted to invest in my own apartment. But your targets and your goals may not just be one. You can actually have multiple targets at the same time. For example, you may want to invest in your own apartment, and at the same time, you may also want to invest in a vehicle that would actually make your commute from one place to another cheaper. You may be looking at attending a school or a college abroad, which definitely has significantly higher fees than what you would typically have in India, but the program is something that you're really looking forward to. Along with that, you may also be looking at investing in a few equipments that would make your study at that program a little more efficient, like investing in a dream laptop or some other equipment that you would need to study that program better. So the most important thing to do here is to write down all of your goals and targets in one place, because a sheet which has all of your goals written in one place will drive you more than anything else to really make them come true. Once you have all of your goals written in one place, the next step is to detail out your goals with data. Now, it's very easy to come up with a goal like, oh, I want to buy my own apartment. But so much of research needs to really go behind just that one decision. So the next step is to really start building upon each one of your goals with more research that you do using online information or speaking to people who you think know more about it. Just around the time when I made the decision to buy my own apartment, I started following a lot of these real estate newspapers. I started reading a lot about the research that was happening about the Indian real estate market, and I started noting down my points. I started considering different cities where the real estate prices were not that expensive. I also started looking at the resale value. I started looking at the year-on-year growth of each of these cities, and any and every information that I thought would be relevant for me to make my dream come true. Now, if your goal is to, say, buy a car, then you would have to start researching about the different cars that are available in the market and the financial requirements that you would have for each of these cars. If your goal is to go study at a program abroad, you would have to start looking at the university, you would have to start looking at the fee structure, you would have to start looking at the student expenses, the living expenses, the different ways in which you would be able to earn your income while you're staying there and things like that. Please don't get overwhelmed at this point by all of the information overload. Take your own good time to do research about this information. I took at least 3 to 4 months to do my research. I spoke to as many people as I could. Do not lack in this part, because this honestly is the most important part of your whole process. The final point that you need to arrive at from this research is the possible investment amount that you would need. Like, my research told me that the possible investment that I would need would be between 30 to 40 lakhs. And I broke that down into 5 to 6 lakhs of down payment that I would need immediately and 25 to 30 lakhs of loan that I will be picking up for my apartment. This gave me a very clear financial requirement that I would need so that I would be able to make clear budgeting and saving requirements accordingly. Now, once you have your clear budget in mind, the next step is to start figuring out your monthly savings. Your monthly savings are eventually going to determine the amount of money that you can possibly save and how long it would take for you to achieve your goals. So go back to my budgeting video. I will definitely leave a link to that in my description box below. and follow that entire process and figure out your monthly savings. List down your income and list down all of your expenses, your non-discretionary expenses like rent, water, electricity, and stuff like that, and discretionary expenses like going out for a movie, vacations, or eating out. And figure out the monthly saving that you possibly can do every month without fail. Break down your savings into savings that would be for general purposes and savings that would particularly be for these goals and targets. The sooner you arrive at your savings that you can possibly do every month, the faster you'll be able to know in how long will you be actually able to achieve your dreams and your targets. Let's say your savings tells you that you will be able to save about 15,000 rupees every month towards your goal and your target of, say, buying a house or buying a car or anything like that. Then we move on to the next step. And this is where the game completely changes. You cannot just save the money, keep it in the bank, and expect to actually make your dream come true quickly. You will have to start making important investment decisions with your money. Now, let's say from the previous step, you were able to figure out that you will be able to save at least 15,000 rupees every month, and this is the amount of money that you'll be investing to make it grow even faster with the interest that you will earn on it. Now, there are a couple of things you can do with this money. You can invest them in low risk or no risk options, or you can invest in medium risk options. Now, low risk or zero risk options will give you very little return in terms of interest, but your medium risk options will definitely give you way higher returns. Your low or medium risk options are things like FD or RD or PPF or even post office savings. If you decide to do that, I would suggest that you visit this particular website called RD Calculator by HDFC Bank. Go ahead, enter the amount of money that you are planning to invest every month. Select the date when you think it would be possible for you to start investing. Select the number of years for which you will be investing this amount on a monthly basis and submit your information. This calculator will quickly calculate the amount of money with interest that you will be getting by the end of your term. This will make your decision process very easy. But in my opinion, while an RD or an FD are definitely safe options, they provide you very little returns. I would suggest investing most of your money in mutual funds. Mutual funds provide much higher returns because they are linked to the stock market, and the returns definitely change with increase or decrease in the stock prices. Now, here's how you can go about choosing the right investment option for you in mutual funds. There is a mutual funds predictor and calculator by Edelweiss, which I find very useful. I'll definitely leave a link to this in the description box below. So this calculator has these different targets that you can set for yourself. So when you enter the link, it will ask you if you want to save money or you have a financial target. So in our case, we definitely have a financial target. Let's say your target requires you to save 5 lakh rupees in 5 years towards whatever your target is. For me, it was home. It will also ask you to enter your age so that it can calculate your risk profile. Once you submit your information, the calculator will automatically look at all of this data and will tell you exactly how much amount of money will you need to invest monthly to achieve your target. Now, this tells me that I need to invest 5,500 rupees monthly to achieve my target of saving 5 lakhs in 5 years. What it will also do is give the list of all of the mutual fund investments in which I should be making my investments. I can definitely change or alter this as per my liking, exactly like how I'm doing on the screen right now. And it will give the list of the funds in which I should invest all of my money to diversify my portfolio by investing in different options. Going down, it will also show you a graph which will show you exactly how your money will rise over the course of this year. This makes it very visual for you to visualize exactly how your money is growing. And on the side, it also tells you exactly how much money will you be earning as a part of your interest. Here you can see it shows about 2 lakhs of money will be earned by investing whatever money we are getting as interest. Now, this is calculating this particular amount at a certain rate of interest. Now, you can also reduce the rate of interest a little to see how, in case the market is not performing too well, the amount of interest that you'll be earning. So you can definitely increase or decrease the rate of interest as per your liking, just to see all possible scenarios. You can also go up and click on the links of the mutual funds that they provide to get more information about each of these mutual funds, which I find very, very useful. So you can have a look at the different graphs, how it has been performing, who is the manager of this fund, and how much interest this particular fund has been offering in the last few years. I honestly relied on this particular calculator heavily for making all of my investment decisions. Now, once this calculator tells you about the funds in which you should invest, you can go ahead and do your own research online, figure out about these funds by looking at a lot of different websites, and based on that, you can make your decision on the kind of investment that you would want to make. Now, the amount of investment and the kind of investment that you'll do is completely dependent on you. You can, of course, go ahead and invest in low-risk options. They will just give you lower returns. It all depends on your risk appetite and what is it that your particular goals are. My opinion would be to go ahead with mutual funds because they offer significantly higher rate of return and are not very risky. After all of your research is done, start investing your money, and in no time you will be closer to your dream than ever. That's it. This is a very simple process. There's no rocket science in this. It's just this simple four-step process that can make even the biggest of your financial dreams come true. Do let me know how you like this video by letting me know in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed watching this video and found it useful, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. I wish you all the luck in your financial journey. Make smart decisions, do reach out for help, and I'll see you next time. Bye!